after leading a select committee that hit the last nail in the censure motion against the State Minister for Housing, Persis Namuganza. Dambara South Division legislator Mwine Mpaka has been named again by the Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayewa to lead another select committee of parliament to investigate scandals in the National Social Security Fund.
Honorable Kankunda Amos Chibwika, I didn't know his second name, Rwampara NRM member. Honorable Bakabrindi Charles, workers, NRM member. And Honorable Mwine Mpaka Ramirama, Nambara City South NRM chairperson. So they are supposed to report back within 1 month. I'm told the whips were consulted. So that's it on that point.
Other committee members include Charles Bakabulindi, the workers' representative, Honorable Karim Masaba, MP Mbale Industrial Division, Michael Kakembo, MP Entebbe Municipality, Fortunate Nantongo, Woman MP Chotera District, Laura Kanushu, MP People with Disabilities, and Amos Kankunda of Rampara County.
We're going to do the best to our abilities to make sure that we find out what exactly is happening and what is wrong. So I can assure everyone out there that we are going to do the best, and perhaps within the shortest time possible, within the 30 days we've been given, we'll have a very good and transparent report on the floor of parliament.
The committee has been handed 5 terms of reference, including corporate governance structures at the NSSF, and examines circumstances surrounding appointment of the fund's managing director. Others include evaluating status and safety of savers' money in the fund and examining the extent of stakeholder engagement in decision-making in the fund, plus any other business. The select committee has been given 1 month to report back to the House. Members of Parliament have welcomed the committee with hope that it will be able to restore sanity at the Workers' Fund in order to rebuild public confidence.
We are looking forward to this committee getting details. Why are several Ugandans out there why have they failed? And we have hope that by the time the committee presents its report, it will give us guidance on how we should proceed as Parliament. And thereafter, we shall be helping several Ugandans who have really saved their money to be in position to access their money and at least to have a better life vis-a-vis what they toiled for.
I'm really very concerned because there's a lot of irregularities, there is a lot of financial mismanagement which are coming out from NSSF. And for the sake of those one who are saving, our people who are saving for NSSF, it is very fundamental that such allegations, which most of them are factual, should be cleared.
Other legislators have cautioned their colleagues named on the committee to resist temptations of bribery and produce a commendable report that highlights issues affecting savers.
I understand on the way they might face challenges of money hitting them in different corners, in different areas, in different corridors, but I just want to appeal to them to reject this money so that they can come out with a report which is going to assist Parliament to make an informed decision on the issues and the matters concerning National Social Security Fund for the money for our workers.
My humble prayer to this committee is to be genuine, not to be bribed, and when they conclude their investigations, I pray, and my humble prayer is, let all the culprits be brought to book so that we save people's money.
Last week, Parliament resolved to institute a committee to inquire into the operations of the NSSF following reports of corruption and mismanagement of the 17.9 trillion fund. The controversy revolved around the reappointment of the then managing director, Richard Biarugaba, who had attained the age of 60 and had already served 2 terms. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.